Hey folks, it's Tom Dehan here, back with another Recombu unboxing, and this time we got the Asus ZenGimbal. Now, strangely enough, this was actually released back in 2020, but we've just now been sent a review unit, and before we get to testing this bad boy, we're going to take a look and see what's inside the box. Let's take a look. Okay, here it is, the Asus ZenGimbal. The box has taken a slight beating in transit, but you know, hopefully there's nothing wrong with the product inside. So let's see if we can get this bad boy open. Let's see if I open that up, get that going, and I think there's a little tag here so we can see what's going on here. What I'll do, I'll put that box to the side for a second, and we'll get this front and center. So, nice hefty case that comes along with this thing. Yeah, I'm interested to know how tightly packed this is, because there is little to no give in the case itself, so maybe there's a lot of padding on the inside. Let's take a look. Open this up. Ooh, there we are. There's the star of the show. So, Asus ZenGimbal. Couple of things to know about this. The headline feature is free 60 degree rotation, which is quite a rare thing to find on a smartphone gimbal. And hopefully what that should mean is that there's a lot more give, or rather the gimbal is more forgiving whilst you're out filming, because with some smartphone gimbals, there is a threshold. Let's say if you turn too quickly in a certain direction, then the motors can get confused and it throws the whole thing out of whack. So if that isn't the case here, then it could be a lot more forgiving, especially for beginners. So it'd be quite interesting to test out. And it's quite a interesting piece of kit. Ooh, let's open that up, see what it's like. I tell you, this is not at all like your typical kind of gimbal setup. Certainly, if you've watched our unboxing for the Zhiyun Smooth Q4, that has a far more sort of intuitive design than this, I guess. Yeah, this one is slightly confusing, has to be said. Not at all like something I've seen before. So I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. Let's see if I can get that set up. I don't know, maybe it's not even. You know what, for the sake of what I will probably end up doing is breaking it if I fiddle around with it too much. So we're going to put it there for a second, see what else is in the box. Right here, we get a nice little tripod extension. Oh, it's quite diddy, but you know what? It's nice to have that there. It's always handy for those time-lapse shots, which always pair so well with a gimbal. Let's see, got a little hot shoe extension. Or rather a little tripod extension there for the bottom. Why not? And I think that might be it for what's inside the case. So what we can do is pop this over to one side for a second and see what else is inside the box. So I think it might literally just be, there's a separate compartment here and it's got whatever this is. Let's have a look. Or maybe I'm going at it the wrong angle. Let's have a look. Okay, little handle there to attach to the bottom. Always nice to have. Ooh, you know what? Okay, yeah, so standard cable there. It is USB-C. Always nice to have. And there's one more thing in here, I believe. Let's have a look. Ooh, a nice little carry case there. If I can ever figure out how to fold this back into the sort of portable position, then I can actually get this thing back in there. But yeah, it's quite a lot that comes with the package itself, which I believe has a retail price of about £139.99, which admittedly is quite expensive compared to the majority of smartphone gimbals, and it does put it in close competition with the high-end ones from Zhiyun and DJI. So I'm intrigued to see whether or not this can really hold up. Certainly, just to take a look at it. So one thing that's worth mentioning here is So you have the clasp here. This actually goes quite near the bottom half of your phone, and what you have here is a counterweight right at the bottom, which allows you to have this design, which you can kind of see on the, there we go, I'm just destroying the little garden that we have, which you can see on the box here. This is not what you usually see on a smartphone gimbal. Usually the clasp would be in the middle and you wouldn't even have a need for a counterweight at all. So I'm intrigued to see how this all works when it's up and running. And that is everything that you get inside the box with the Asus ZenGimbal. Let us know in the comments below if you'd like to purchase one of these bad boys. And if you haven't done so already, make sure to subscribe to Recombu for the latest in tech.